In this video, I'm going to cover uploading in PHP, so I'm going to create a new folder and call it 19_uploading. And in here, I'm going to create a PHP web page and call it index. And I'll just get rid of the comment and these PHP tags. And I need a form in here. Form action is going to be empty, so I'm going to handle the form submission on this page. And the method is going to be post. And I'm going to have an input of type file in this form, so I need to specify that as well here. So I'm going to say anctype, and that's going to be equal to multipart/form-data. And now in here I'm going to have a p, and here I'll have a label, and I'm going to say upload image, and I'm going to have that file input here with the name of image, let's say, and I don't need the ID. And I have another P with a button, and I'll say upload here. And finally, I'm gonna have a hidden input, so I can check for form submission with the name of submitted and value true. And up here above doc type, I'm gonna have PHP tags. Okay, so to just upload a file in PHP, it's really easy actually. You just need one function. The hard part is to check for MIME types, display errors, and so on. But just uploading is a piece of cake actually, which I'm gonna do now. First of all, inside of the uploading folder, 19uploading, I'm gonna create a subfolder and call it uploads, where I'm gonna store the uploads. And here I'm gonna say if is set post submitted, so if the form is submitted. And here I'm gonna define the upload dir, which is gonna be uploads, so this one, so uploads and a forward slash I'll have as well. And when you upload a file in PHP, the data related to that file is in the files superglobal array. Okay, so I can store the name in a variable here of the uploaded file. So I'm gonna say here file name, like so. And that's gonna be equal to files. And then here goes the name of the element, so in this case it's image, and then name, which just exists in the file superglobal. This name, it's built in. And here I can also say, for example, let's say the name of the file has spaces, so I can say here str replace and have this instead of parentheses. And I can replace those spaces with dashes, let's say, or underscores. Let it be underscores. And now to just upload the file, there's the function called move_uploaded_file. You can see it right here in my IDE. So first it takes a string argument, file name, and the second is the destination. So the file name, when you first want to upload, is actually files and image, which is the name of the input element, and then tmp_name, temporary name. You have to have it like so because PHP first assigns it a temporary name and then its real name once it's uploaded. So you have to have it like so. And then the destination is gonna be uploadir. And I'm gonna append the file name to that. That's why I had a slash here, the forward slash. If I didn't, then I would need to have something like this, let's say. Okay. And this just like so should work. So let me run this and see. This is coming from somewhere, let's see. I have this double less than here. Okay, so if I refresh, and I choose a file, and I have this source folder, which you can download as a zip from the last lecture, and it's going to contain the this images folder, which I'm going to use now, and it's going to contain this whole PHP MySQL course folder with all the source files and maybe even some other stuff, because I am still in the process of doing the course. So anyway, just download that file, and in the source you have these images. So here they are, and if I, let's say, take this Better Days image and upload, hopefully it's been uploaded, let's see, and there it is. Okay, and if I upload, let's say, Road and Sky, which has spaces, and upload, there it is. So it's being uploaded. So that is the simplest way of uploading a file in PHP. That's it for this video, and I'm gonna make this script more robust in the next video. Okay, see you then.